Hi, this is Gary with macmost.com. Let me show you how you can copy the items in a reminders list in macOS Catalina with the help of a script. Macmost is made possible thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to macmost.com/patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So the problem here is in Catalina, you can't copy these items here and paste them into a piece of text. You can't print them. There's no print function. There's no way to get these into another document or to print them out in some way. You can kind of use iCloud.com, the web app there, to do it, but it's a little tricky and doesn't work very well. However, you can write a script to do it pretty easily. So let's say we want to get this list and we want to be able to copy it so we can paste it into text edit, pages, numbers, whatever. I'm going to start with Script Editor. Script Editor is in the Applications folder, in the Utilities folder. I'll show you at the end how to do this in Automator as well. Now we're going to end up with a pretty long script in Script Editor, and if you're not a programmer it can be kind of intimidating. So I want to start off with the simplest version of that script, which is just 4 lines long, just to show you how you can do the most basic version of this with just 4 lines. So in Script Editor you want to create a new script and you want to make sure you set it to JavaScript. And in JavaScript most of them start off with the same 2 lines. That's just basically to declare we're going to be using the app called Reminders. And then we're going to do something called include standard editions and set that to true. That basically says we're going to be using the app called Reminders and we're going to be scripting it. Now we're going to do most of the work with 1 line of code. We're going to start with a variable called text and we're going to put the text into that we want to put into the clipboard. We're going to go with the app Reminders and get the lists from it. So you've got a bunch of different lists, like for instance here we've got Reminder, Shopping List, and To-Do List. Okay, so we'll get the lists. Then we're going to look for the one by name that has this exact name in it. So this simple piece of code has hard-coded in it the name of the list. If you wanted to get another list, you have to edit the code and change that name. Then we're going to get the reminders from that list. So this is just basically the list. This is the reminders inside that list. Then we're going to use a function called name. We know it's a function because it's got the little parentheses there. This name function is basically going to get all the name properties of all of those items. And it's going to give us that in an array, which is basically a list of items inside of JavaScript. So we now end up with this, with a list of all of the names of all the reminders in the shopping list. We're going to then use a JavaScript function called join, which takes a list or array like this and converts it to text. And it's going to put in between each item a line break. So every item is going to be on its own line. And that's going to be in text. So now that we have that in text, we can just use the set the clipboard to and set it to that text. Let's run it. And nothing seems to happen because all it did was put something in the clipboard. Let's go to text edit. I've got a blank document here and I'll paste in there. And there it is. All the items from this reminders list, this shopping list. Notice a couple things. First, we don't have any notes. So here it says bread, whole wheat. That's not there because the name of this item is bread. The note is whole wheat. We only got the names. The other thing is there's 7 items here, but this one has more. Where did they come from? Well, this is only showing us the non-completed items on the list. We had those items in this list previously and we checked them off. We completed them. Our script doesn't care about that. It's going to get everything whether it's completed or not completed. So in a lot of different ways this isn't a very good script. It does the most basic thing. So let's go and expand on this and create something very comprehensive. So here's a complete script that does a lot. I'm going to include the code for this in the post at macmost.com. So you could just follow along here and then you can copy and paste later. So we're going to start off exactly the same way. We just say we're using the Reminders app and we want to script it. Now we're going to go and allow the user to choose which list they want. So we're going to use choose from list. We're going to pass 2 parameters. The first is the list of items to choose from. So app.list.name. So we're going to get all of the names of the lists. Not the reminders, but the lists. So in reminders here we've got Reminders, Shopping List, and To-Do. So it's going to get those 3 names and it's going to add the prompt, which list? So when I run this, this is what you see. Which list? And it shows you those 3 there. It's going to cancel out of that. We'll get back to looking at the script. If the list name, then we're going to do all the rest of this stuff. You can see everything else here is going to be performed only in the condition that we have a list name. If we don't, it's going to skip it all. So if you cancel or don't select a list, then there's no error message, nothing. It just doesn't do anything. Now, we have a list name, so let's get the reminders from that. So we're going to do what we did in the last script. We're going to get from the Reminders app the lists, get the one by name that matches the list name, and get all of the reminders. And then we're going to get four different aspects of all of those reminders. We're going to get the list names, which we're going to use .name like we did before. But we're also going to get list completed, the completed property of each one of those. And that's going to be a true or false. So that's .completed. The list of due dates, .due date. And the list of the bodies of each reminder. Bodies is the technical term here for the note that's included with each reminder. So .body. So now we have four different arrays instead of just one with the names. Now we're going to create our own JavaScript array. So we're going to call that list and have that be an empty array. Then we're going to loop through all of the list names and we're going to push onto our new list here an object that looks like this. Name colon, completed colon, due date colon, body colon. And each one of those is going to take one element from each of these four lists. So we're going to combine those four lists. What we're going to end up with is something that looks like this. A list and each item is going to look like this. So name, eggs, completed, false is not completed, due date, null, there's no due date there, body, null. And then it's going to be milk and bread. You can see bread has an actual body, a note called whole wheat. If any of them had a due date, we'd have a date there rather than null. And it's going to be a complete list of all of them. That's what it's going to look like behind the scenes. Now I'm going to skip this section here and get back to that later. That's just all commented out. So it's not doing anything right now. Now we're going to build some text from that list. So we have an array in JavaScript. That's not what we want. What we want is a piece of text so we can paste it into TextEdit or whatever. So we're going to create a piece of text that's just blank. We're also going to keep track of the number of items in the list. So we're going to just call that n and set that to 0 for now. Then we're going to loop through all of the items in our new list array. And then we're going to get for each item a piece of text. And that text is going to start off with the name. So just take whatever the name is. So eggs, for instance. Then we're going to look and see, is there a due date? If there is a due date, then add to that piece of text a bracket with the word due and a colon and then the due date and then a close bracket. Only put that there if there is a due date. If not, don't bother to put anything there. Same thing for a note. We're going to look at the body. If it exists, we're going to add to the item something with, you know, bracket, note, colon, space, and then that note and a bracket. But only if there is a note. Otherwise, these two lines won't do anything. You'll just end up with just the name like eggs. Then we're going to go and take that item and see if it's completed. If it is not completed, the not represented by this little exclamation point there, then we're going to add it to the text variable there. We're going to put a little box before it. I just use the character chooser, you know, control command space, and I search for a box with an empty box there with no check mark in it, and then a space, and then that whole piece of text that we generated here, and then a new line. And we're going to do the same thing if it's a completed item. So this is not completed, and this is completed. It's else. So it's if it's completed. But the only difference here is we're going to do a check mark in there. And then we've got, in both cases, n++. So add 1 to n. So every time it puts a line in there, it's going to add 1. So if it does it for 7 items, we'll have the number 7 in n. Then we're going to use that exact same piece of code from our short script before to put all of that text into the clipboard. Then I'm going to display an alert. The reason I'm going to do that is because this could take a few seconds to run, especially if the list is long. So we're going to display basically a I'm done message. And we're going to use that N there in the message to say 7 items copied to the clipboard, just so you have some information. So let's run this and see what happens. I'll run. I'll select the shopping list. I'll hit OK. It says 11 copied to the clipboard. I'll hit OK there. I'll go to TextEdit. Let's delete this and I'll paste in the new results. And now you can see all the results there. I have check marks next to the completed item so I know what's going on there. And I've got notes for 3 of them. Let's go ahead and make a little modification here. Let's say I don't want to see completed items. All I need to do is comment out these two lines. Now when I run it, and I select shopping list, it's going to say 7 items copied to the clipboard. And when I look and paste those in, you'll see it just doesn't include the completed items. Let's try it again, but for this to-do list here. And it's going to say three items copied to the clipboard. To-do list actually has three items, all with due dates, one with a note. So now we go to Text Edit. I'll paste these in. You can see all three items there. Each one has a due date. And this one has a due date and also a note. One last thing I want to show you is that in this script we had some sorting options here. So I commented these lines out. If you are using manual sort here in Reminders like I always do, then you're going to get that same manual sort here. But if you sort, say, by title or due date, you're still going to get manual sort here unless you say, oh no, sort it by something. So I can uncomment this line and now it's going to sort the list using the names. If I instead were to uncomment this line, it's going to sort by the due dates. And I can change the direction by changing this here from greater than to less than. So there's a sorting option there. I'm going to leave them commented. That's the way I want them. But if you wanted to go a further step, you could start working with those. Now what if you wanted to put this in Automator? And I'll show you why you may want to do that in a second here. I'm going to select all and copy. And then I'm going to run Automator. I'm going to create a new document in Automator. And let's say we want to do a quick action. And then I'm going to say the workflow receives no input, but it only runs in Reminders. So I'll go any application and I'll go to Reminders. Now I'm going to search for run JavaScript here and I'm going to add that. And see where it says your script here? I'm just going to paste all of that code in there just as is. And then I'm going to save it and I'll call it Copy Reminders and Save. So now it should work the same. It's just that it's inside Automator, so it was very easy for us to put it in there as a quick action. So let's go to the Reminders app here and I'll then go to Reminders, Services, and I'll see Copy Reminders. I can run that and then it's going to ask for which list. Let's do the shopping list again. And it's going to say 7 copies to the clipboard. I can go to Text Edit and paste those in. So now I have a convenient way to access this script instead of having it be a file somewhere and having to open it up in Script Editor to run it. Hopefully eventually you'll be able to copy directly from Reminders, but until then this script will do the trick. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.